that's the advice that I understand you've been given.
I think the report that the Royal Committee sets out the information which we believe can be made public. I think if we go, if we were to discuss any further issues any further, we would probably be looking at some exempt information which shouldn't be aired as a public meeting.
Okay, that being said, Ian, you still want to
I just want to be clear that in 8.3 where we're saying a report would be an update would be brought to the next meeting of the planning committee. That would be for the planning committee to discuss this issue.
It will, but it will be drafted as a part two report.
That's what I understand. Yes. Yeah. So I'm clear to accept Councillor Foulkes' points and the legal advice we receive that this issue is going to be discussed by the committee. Yes.
Stuart?
Just slightly uncomfortable with part of the sentence in 8.1. I'll read the part of the sentence that I'm uncomfortable with. It starts, and that therefore.
Is this the amendment? Yes. Or,
yeah. Yeah, we got and that therefore, etc., all the way to full stop, years only. It strikes me that the phrasing of that seems to negate, if you like, the idea that we are going to get further legal options. Because all of that sentence from and that to years only is written as a statement of fact, that there it is, it can't, it's not subject. And my view was, or my hope was, that the part two report would actually explore those issues in a little more detail.
Yeah. As I've said, the position is currently that legally the development can continue on site. They have a planning permission. I'm really looking to debate this too much. They have a current planning permission which enables them to have the marquees on site. There are options legally that the council can look at, but I don't want to discuss those in a public forum.
Okay, Stuart? Okay, so we're happy that another report will be brought to us in August when all of the facts are known. Okay? All right, well, that being said, can I